I have some 18650 unprotected batteries that I bought, and I bought those in March of 2019, and I use these to convert Mag-Lite flashlights to lithium batteries. I'm going to add a protection circuit to these. I found this one, which already has the nickel-plated straps spot welded to the contacts, and it comes with this little plastic insulator. This insulator has a slot in it here that's flush with this surface, and this one is a bit recessed. So there is a right and a wrong way to put that on here. And that recessed part goes on the long tab, which is the positive end. And that one goes through there like that. This one will eventually get bent this way and go up the length of the battery. The tricky part is we need to spot weld this to the bottom of the battery and do it such that when we fold it over, it's nice and concentric and flush all the way around. I'm going to use the spot welding pen. It's a little easier to get in here with the pen to spot weld these strips on here with that plastic insulator and that circuit board in the way. You need to remember, don't let these electrode holders touch each other. Be using the foot switch. We have this set to 8. 8 is just the number. 1 is the lowest, 8 is the highest. And I'm setting it to 8 pulse. Once you figure out your settings, do a little bit of a production setup here. And I am at a 8 pulse and a setting of 8. This high temperature tape comes in different widths, and this is the same thing that was holding the insulation on the hot end on my 3D printer. After I spot weld these to the negative end of the battery, I put a strip of this high temperature tape on here. Lay that down, hold this straight, and I take a little piece of tape, put it on there to hold that in position. These are 5 amp protection circuits. 5 amps is not very much, but should this strip get hot, it could melt through the original heat shrink that's on the battery. Then this would be touching the case of the battery, and the protection circuit would be bypassed. A little high temperature tape on there is a little added protection, and those hold that in position just until I get a chance to spot weld this to the positive end of the battery. Then we put a heat shrink tube over all of that. And that's the reason for using these self-adhesive insulating rings. It puts another layer around here for this strap to bend around and keeps it away from this original heat shrink. This end of the battery has a plastic protector on here as well. It's just a little added precaution. Once again, I'm at a setting of 8 on the amperage and 8 pulse. This is an assortment of pre-cut heat shrink tube, and these are cut to the perfect length for an 18650 with the protection circuit on it, and they shrink up real well. And the heat shrink tubing just goes on there, and you space it evenly on each end. Just to recap a bit of what we're doing here, this is an 18650 lithium battery. That means that it's 18 millimeters in diameter, and originally it was 650 millimeters long. And since we've added this protection device, it is now about 675 millimeters long, because we've added the thickness of this protection circuit and the little plastic base that it fits into. Without the protection circuit, and I bought these as unprotected cells, if you short this battery out, it will give up all of its energy almost instantaneously. It'll get real hot and potentially could explode and or catch fire. When you contact the end of this battery now, you're actually contacting this plate, which is part of this circuitry, and is connected to this part that we spot welded to the base of the battery. And then this is spot welded over here, so when we make connection here, all the current, either charging or discharging, goes through this circuit board. And this protects it from overcharging. The voltage range for one of these batteries is 2.5 volts to 4.2 volts. They call it 3.7 because that's the average voltage from the fully charged to allowable discharge. That's 3.7 is the average voltage. This circuit keeps this from overcharging. It'll turn off and prevent you from charging this over about 4.2 volts. Let's say you have this in a flashlight or some device and it's running. If you take this battery down below 2.5 volts, it will probably be ruined. So the circuitry will turn the battery off if the voltage gets too low. So it's protecting the battery from being over-discharged. If you somehow short-circuit the battery, this will provide overcurrent protection. If this detects that you have a short or you're drawing way too much amperage for this battery, it's going to shut down. So overcharge, over-discharge, or low voltage, short circuit, or overcurrent protection. The remaining question is, will it fit in my battery charger? Yes, it will. It's a little tighter, but still works.